So good morning, guys. I hope you guys be safe in the home listening. So during this pandemic period, our classes will be going through the online model. I hope you guys be safe in the home, okay? And it's supposed to be land very clearly, okay? Clear. So today's sessions we are going to see about the addition of vectors and the subtraction of vectors, okay? So before we go for our today's sessions, first we are going for the previous sessions, okay? Let's go through the previous sessions. So for previous sessions, what are the ones we learned that the motion one dimensions, motion 1, 2, 1, 3 dimension. Then we see the scalar and vector quantity. Then we see the different types of vectors, isn't it? So first, guys, what is the scalar motion one dimension? We know the coordinates. What is that? We know the coordinates which specify the position of object, x, y, and z. If the coordinates are changes with respect to time, what is that? If the coordinates are changes with respect to the time means, then it is called as a motion. Further, if the one of the coordinates will be changes with respect to time means, then it is called as a motion in one dimension. Isn't it? So we see the motion in one dimension, motion in two dimensions, and the motion in three dimensions. So motion in one dimension means a particle will be moving on a straight line. The motion of a particle will be on a straight line means, then it is called as a motion in one dimension, in which one of the three coordinates which will be changes with respect to time. What is that? The one of the three coordinates are changes with respect to time. That's called as a motion in one dimension. That's called as a motion in one dimension. Examples, we know that the train will be moving on a parallel track and the object will be fall under due to gravity. The next one is on motion in two dimension. So guys, what is motion in two dimension? Motion in two dimension. What is motion in two dimension? If an object will be moving on a curved path, what is that? If an object will be moving on a curved path means that's called as a motion in two dimension, in which the two of the three coordinates are changes with respect to time. The last one, the motion in three dimension. If an object, one of an object will be moving in a three-dimensional space in three-dimensional means, then it is called as a motion in three dimensions. Examples, motion of a gas molecules in a random manner, then a bird will be flying over the sky. Isn't it? Then next we see the scalar vector. What is the scalar? Scalar is a property, is described by its magnitude. What is that? The scalar is a property, is described by its magnitude. Then we see the vector. Vector means they have is a property, they have both magnitude and directions. Both magnitude and direction. Then we see the different types of vectors, isn't it? Different types of vectors, isn't it? So what are the different types of vectors? We see that the equal vectors, then collinear vector, then unit vector, then orthogonal vectors. So what is equal vector? The two vectors are said to be equal. What is that? The two vectors are said to be equal if they have a same magnitude and directions. Then what is collinear vector? Collinear vectors are vector, they are acting on the same line. So the angle between the vectors will be 0 degree or 180 degree. If the angle between the two vectors are 0 degree means, then it is called as a parallel vector. If the angle between the two vectors are 180 degree means, they are called as an anti-parallel vectors. They are called as an anti-parallel vectors. Okay, the next one is a unit vector. What is unit vector? A vector divides by its own magnitude is called as a, what is that? A vector is divides by its own magnitude is called as a unit vector. The last one is an orthogonal vector, isn't it? So orthogonal vector means, simply can say is that the two vectors are said to be perpendicular to each other, then it is said to be orthogonal vectors. Then the angle between the two vectors will be 90 degree. What is that? The angle between the two vectors will be 90 degree. Then today's sessions, we are going, till then we see in the previous sessions, and today's sessions we are going to see about the additions and subtractions of vectors. Okay? Addition and the subtractions of two vectors. So the vectors are, what is that? The vectors have both magnitude and directions, right? So the vectors have both magnitude and directions. So since the vectors have both magnitude and directions, they cannot be added by the ordinary algebra, okay? They cannot be added by an ordinary algebra, okay? Okay. So since the vectors have both magnitude and directions, so they cannot be added by a modal algebra or normal algebra. Okay, or ordinary algebra. So these vectors can be added by. What is that? These vectors can be added by a certain method of geometrically or analytically by a certain rules. That's called as a vector algebra. Okay. So what is vector algebra? The vectors can be added by geometrically or analytically. What is that? The vectors can be added by geometrically or analytically by a certain rules. What is that? By a certain rules. That's called as a vector algebra. So what's the first point? We say that the two vectors that can be, because the vectors are both magnitude and directions, so they cannot be added by a ordinary algebra. So the vectors should be added by geometrically or analytically by a certain rules are called as a vector algebra. So the two vectors can be added by two methods. Okay, one is a triangulation law of vectors. Then second one, the parallelogram law of vectors. Okay, the two vectors can be added by, what is that? The two vectors can be added by either the two method. One is that the triangle law of vectors, and the second one is the parallelogram law of vectors. One is that triangle law of vectors, and another one is the parallelogram law of vectors. Okay, so here first we are going to see about the triangle law of vectors. So before I am going to this questions, this question is one of a repeated board exam question. Okay, clear? The triangle law of vectors for this second lesson. This is our first final question, first important board exam question. Okay, so when we are back to the school, your note, you have to write down your note. Okay, the triangle law of vectors. Okay, so we know that the two vectors, what is that? The two vectors are we know the vector is right. So if we use the vector means, this will be a tail and this will be a head. Okay, clear? So here we are assuming the two vectors which represents the adjacent side of a triangle means. So we know the triangle is right. So this is a three sides of a triangle. If the two vectors, A vector and B vector, represents the two adjacent sides of a triangle means. Okay, if two vectors, what is that? Okay, so A vector and B vector, if represents the two adjacent sides of a triangle means, then the resultant vector will be taken as the third side of a triangle in a reverse order. Okay, the resultant vector is taken as a, what is that? The resultant vector is taken as a, the resultant vector is taken as the third side of a triangle in a reverse order. What is that? The resultant vector will be taken as the third side. What is that? The resultant will be given by the third side of a triangle in the reverse order. So what's the triangle of vectors? The two vectors, A vector and B vector, we are going to find the resultant vector. So here using a first, we have two types of additional methods, isn't it? One is the triangle of vectors and other one is the parallelogram law of vectors. One is the triangle of vectors, other one is the parallelogram law of vectors. So here the first one, the triangle law of vectors. So the two vectors, A vector and B vector, represents the two sides of a triangle means, then the resultant vector is given by the third side of a triangle in the reverse order. So this is the statement of triangle of vectors. So what is the triangle of vectors? The two vectors which represents the two sides of a triangle means, then the resultant vector is given by the third side of a triangle in a reverse order. Third side of a triangle in a reverse order. So how it should be added means, O A B. okay, O A always O P Q. Okay, so here the head of a first vector, what is that? The head of a first vector is added to the tail of a second vector. Okay, the head of a first vector will be added to the tail of a second vector. Then the resultant vector, for a resultant vector, the tail of a first vector is added to the head of a second vector. Okay, so if a head of a first vector is added to the tail of a second vector, means then the resultant vector, then the resultant vector, the tail of a first vector will be added to the head of a second vector. The tail of a second vector, tail of a first vector will be added to the head of a second vector. Head of a second vector. So what you get? O Q vector is equal to O P vector plus P Q vector. So you get the R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector. The R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector. Clear? 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 Head down. So say that one. So how the triangle of vectors are? The two vectors which represents the two sides of a triangle, means then the resultant of a triangle will be taken in a reverse order. So here the head of a first vector will be added to the tail of a second vector, means then the resultant vector, the tail of a second vector, what is that? So tail of a first vector will be added to the head of a first vector. Okay, clear. So here we are going to find the magnitude and, okay, next we are going to find the magnitude and resultant. What is that? We are going to find the magnitude and resultant. Magnitude and direction of resultant. Okay, clear, clear. So here, so it will be an A vector. So O A vector, O A B. So if this is a B vector, it is an R vector. So R vector makes an angle will be alpha. Okay. So here we are going to extend OA to AN. OA to AN with the angle of theta. With the angle of theta. So we are going to extend OA to AN with the angle of theta. Okay, clear? So guys, shall I this up? Any doubt on this? So what's the point? Can we say that if a two vectors represents the two sides of a triangle, means the resultant will be represented by the adjacent, what is the close that side of a triangle in a reverse order. Okay, then we see that what's the point? We see that then what's the point? We see that the head of a first vector will be added to the tail of a second vector, means the resultant vector, the head, the tail of a first vector will be added to the head of a second vectors. Okay, so here we make a triangle OAB. Okay, OA will be represented by A vector, AB will be represented by B vector. So the R vector will be represented by the that side of a triangle reverse order. So here we are extending OA to AN. Okay, clear? Extending OA to AN. Clear? So before we go for that, we are going to find the first, we are going to find the magnitude of the magnitude of a resultant vector. Okay, so from the figure, okay, from the figure, the triangle ABN, BAN, what is that? From the triangle ABN, okay, so from the triangle, what is that? From the triangle BAN or ABN, from the triangle ABN, we are going to find the sine theta and cos theta. Okay, so from the triangle ABN, otherwise BAN, we are going to find. So we can write BAN, right? Okay. We are going to find the sine theta and cos theta. So what guys, what's the formula for sine theta? Opposite side by hypotenuse. What's the formula for cos theta? Adjacent side by hypotenuse, isn't it? So first we are going to find the sine theta. So guys, what's the formula for sine theta? Guys, what's the formula for sine theta? Opposite side by hypotenuse is length. So right, sine theta is equal to BN by AB. BN by AB. So guys, what is the AB? Oh guys, what is the B? AB means B vector, is right? So AB means B. So substitute the BN by B. From this, BN is equal to B into sine theta. Okay? So what's the value of BN in theta? B into sine theta. The rest, the same triangle, we are going to find the cos theta. Guys, what's the formula for cos theta? Adjacent side by hypotenuse. So what is adjacent side? AN. What is hypotenuse? AB. Right? So sine cos theta is equal to AN by AB. So what do you get the AN by B? So from this you can write the AN is equal to B into cos theta. AN is equal to B into cos theta. Okay? Clear? Clear. So what's the point? We are going to extend OA to AN with the angle of theta. So we make a triangle BAN. From the triangle, we find the value of sine theta and cos theta. So what's the formula for sine theta? Adjacent side, sorry, opposite side by hypotenuse. So here theta is the opposite side, BN by AB. The value of AB is equal to B. So BN by we take cross multiplication, BN is equal to B into sine theta. BN is equal to B into sine theta. Similarly, we find the cos theta, adjacent side by hypotenuse, so AN by AB, so AN by B, we take cross multiply, AN is equal to AB into cos theta. Okay? Clear? Any doubt? Doubt now, isn't it? So, next. So, we just find that what are the terms is there, okay? So, OA means what? So, from the triangle, OBN. Okay, from the triangle, what is that? From the triangle OBN. Okay, from the triangle OBN. So, from the triangle OBN. Guys, you know the Pythagoras theorem, isn't it? Guys, what is Pythagoras theorem? Sum of the square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of other two sides, isn't it? You guys know the Pythagoras theorem, isn't it? So what is Pythagoras theorem? Sum of the square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of other two sides. So, from the triangle OBN. So the square of hypotenuse, OB square is equal to other two sides, ON square plus BN square. Right? ON square plus BN square. ON square plus BN square. Clear? By using a Pythagoras theorem or Pythagoras theorem, the sum of the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of other two sides. So OB square is equal to ON square plus BN square. The value of ON is equal to OA plus AN. The value of ON is equal to OA plus AN. So if you substitute the above expression, is what you get now? The ON is equal to OA plus AN. Clear? Substitute the OB square is equal to OA plus AN the whole square plus BN square. Guys, you guys know the A plus B the whole square formula, isn't it? So guys, what's the formula for A plus B the whole square? A square plus B square plus 2AB, isn't it? So right? OB square is equal to, what is that? OB square is equal to, what do you get down? OA square plus B square, isn't it? A square plus B square plus 2OA into AN 2AB plus BN square. Clear? Clear. End up. So OB square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB into BN square. Okay. Now we are going to substitute the value of every time. So right. OB is equal to the resultant vector R. Okay. The resultant vector R. then OA is equal to A, OB is equal to B. Then we find the value of BN and AN. BN is equal to B sin theta, AN is equal to B cos theta. So we substitute that OB square is equal to R square is equal to OA square is equal to A square plus AN square. What is AN? B cos theta, isn't it? So right, B square cos square theta. Because AN square, isn't it? So B square cos square theta plus 2 into OA. What's the value of OA? A. What's the value of AN? B cos theta. So A into B into cos theta plus. Guys, what's the value of BN square? B square sin square theta, right? B square sin square theta. Clear? Clear? So we substitute the value of every term. OB square is equal to R square. OA is equal to A. Then AN square is equal to, we find the value B square cos square theta. Then OA is equal to A. Then AN is equal to B cos theta plus B square sin square theta. So from this two term, B square is common term, right? So if you take an outside, is what you get the R square is equal to A square plus B square. We take an outside, is what you get the cos square theta plus sin square theta plus 2AB cos theta. Guys, what's the value of cos square theta plus sin square theta? What's the value of cos square theta plus sin square theta? 1, isn't it? So right, cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So what's the remaining term you get? R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So from this expression, R is equal to what you get? Root of. R is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Okay, R square plus A square plus 2AB cos theta. So first we find the magnitude of our two vectors. So we know the value of R, isn't it? So what is the result term? Adding of two vectors, isn't it? So if a vector, so what is that? The AB vector which makes an angle theta means. So what is that delta? A vector plus B vector is equal to root of A square plus B square 2AB cos theta. Okay? Clear? A square plus B square. A vector plus B vector plus root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Clear? End up? So I hope you guys see this, isn't it? So what's the from the triangle OBN? What is that? From the triangle OBN, already we know the formula, right? For right angle theorem, sum of the square hypotenuse plus sum of the square other process, isn't it? So OB square is equal to OA square plus BN square. The value of OAN is equal to O A plus A N. Okay, then O A, this substitute the, then we are expanding by A square plus B square formula. So you get the result that R is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Clear? Clear. Then next, we are going to find the we find the magnitude, isn't it? Then we are going to find the direction. Then next we are going to find the direction. Okay, the direction of a two vectors. So from the triangle BON, OBN. Guys, you say the formula for tan alpha. Guys, what's the formula for tan alpha? Guys, what's the formula for tan alpha? Opposite side by hypotenuse, isn't it? Opposite side by hypotenuse. So what's the opposite side? BN by ON. BN by ON. So alpha is the, this will be the opposite side, this will be the adjacent side. BN by ON. But we know that ON is equal to OA plus AN, is it? So substitute the BN by OA plus AN. BN by OA plus AN. BN by OA plus AN. Okay, clear. So already we find the value of BN, B into sine theta. What's the value of OA? A. What's the value of AN? B into cos theta. Isn't it? So substitute the tan alpha is equal to. What's the value of BN? We find B into sine theta. B into sine theta divided by what's the value of OA? A. Then what's the value of AN? B into cos theta. Okay. So from this, the alpha is equal to what is the? Alpha is equal to tan inverse of. Alpha is equal to tan inverse of B into sin theta by A plus B into cos theta. Clear? So this is the direction of a two vectors. What is that? The direction of a resultant two of resultant vectors. Okay? The direction of a resultant vectors. Because R vector is the resultant vector which makes an angle alpha, isn't it? R vector is the resultant vector which makes an angle alpha. So this is the direction of a resultant vectors. Clear? Any doubt? So here we find the magnitude and the resultant of vectors. Okay. So I hope this is the last time this is written, isn't it? So I write here. Okay. So what's the line I write here means? So I hope this much only comes to the end. So here we know R vector is equal to A vector plus B vector, isn't it? So right? So what's the last here? What I write means R vector is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Here, after the writer one step, okay? I think you guys didn't see that. That's why I write that. What is R vector? The second of two vectors, isn't it? So A vector plus B vector. So right? A vector plus B vector is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Okay? Clear? Clear. So here, what is the addition of two vectors? So since the vectors have both magnitude and directions, what is that? Since the vectors have both magnitude and directions, what is that? Since the vectors have both magnitude and directions. Since the vectors have both magnitude and directions, so the two vectors can be added by a, cannot be added by a ordinary algebra. So there can be two vectors can be added by geometrically or analytically by a modern set of rules is called as a vector algebra. So the two vectors, what is that? The vectors can be added by two methods. One is the triangle of vectors, second one is the parallelogram of vectors. So here first we are going to see, because the parallelogram of vectors will be an appendix, okay? In the back of book, the parallelogram of vectors will be there. So here we are going to see the triangle of vectors. So for triangle of vectors means, if the two vectors represents the two sides of a triangle means, then the resultant will be represents the third side of a triangle in a reverse order. The third side of a triangle in a reverse order. The third side of a triangle in a reverse order. Okay? Clear? Clear. So the two vectors which represents the two sides of a triangle means, the third vectors will be represented by the third side of a triangle reverse order. So here, how it should be added means, the head of a first vector is added to the tail of a second vector means, then the resultant vector, the tail of a first vector will be added to the head of a first vector. Head of a first vector. So you can write the OB vector is equal to OA vector plus AB vector. In the book, first we write some PQ, isn't it? So OQ vector is equal to OP vector plus PQ vector. So for this, we are going to find the magnitude and the direction of a resultant vectors. So first, the magnitude of a resultant vector, we are extending OA to AN. We are extending OA to AN. Okay, so we are extending OA to AN, which makes an angle theta. So from the triangle of ABN or BAN, we find this value of sine theta and cos theta. So for sine theta, opposite side by hypotenuse. So theta is here, this will be an opposite side, this will be a hypotenuse. So BN by AB. That's what's the value of AB? B. So BN by B. So if you cross multiply means BN is equal to B into sine theta. BN is equal to B into sine theta. So for cos theta, adjacent side by hypotenuse. So what's adjacent side? AN by AB. So an by b, we take cross multiply, an is equal to b into cos theta. Okay, so we just find the sin theta and cos theta. Then from the triangle of OBN, from the triangle of OBN, okay, we find the sum of the square of hypotenuse is equal to sum of the square of other two sides. So OB square is equal to, what is that? OB square is equal to ON square plus BN square. Okay, so what's the value of ON? OA plus AN. So OA plus AN, we substitute there. So OB square is equal to OA plus AN the whole square plus BN square. So here A plus B the whole square. We are expanding in A plus B the whole square. So guys, what's A square plus B square? A square plus B square plus 2AB plus BN square. Then we are substituting value of OB means R, OA means A, OB means B. Okay, substitute the OB square, R square plus A square plus the value of AN, B square cos square theta plus 2A into, what's the value of AN? B cos theta plus B square sin square theta. From this two term, B square is common, cos square plus theta plus sin square theta. So cos square theta plus sin square theta is equal to 1. So what do you get? R square is equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So R is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. So that is the magnitude of our resultant vectors. If the R vector will be represented by the angle theta, alpha means the vector A vector plus B vector is equal to root of A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. Then we find the directions. If R vector makes the angle alpha in a triangle OBN. So from the triangle OBN. From the triangle OBN, what's the value of tan alpha? What's the value of tan alpha? Alpha is the opposing side by adjacent side. So BN by ON. So BN by OA plus AN. So we substitute means what is delta? Tan alpha is equal to B into sin theta by A plus B into cos theta. A plus B into cos theta, because BN value B into sin theta, AN value B into cos theta. From this alpha, if a tan will be moved to the right hand side, 1 by tan, that can be expressed by tan inverse. So tan inverse into B into sin theta by A plus B into cos theta. So here, understand? So I hope you understand, this will be one of the repeated board exam question, triangle of vectors. Okay, clear? Clear. So I hope you understand the question. You should, when you are back to the school, you should write this question or not. Okay, thank you guys.